We're going to cover work problems in this video, but first of all, let's just take an example of what we mean by work. Let's say Tom takes 12 hours to paint a house. What is his rate per hour? So what this is saying is he could complete one job in 12 hours. So how much of the job does he get done per hour? So let's see if we can figure that out. When I say alone, it takes him 12 hours alone to complete the job of painting a house. So what would his rate per hour be? How much of the job would he get done per hour? That's just 1/12. So each hour he gets 1/12 of the job done. So his rate is 1/12. Now, if he works 12 hours, right? If he works for 12 hours, does it make sense that he gets the whole job done? Hopefully that makes sense to you. Let's say we have Tom again with taking 12 hours to paint a house. His rate again would be 1/12, but let's say he only works for 6 hours. That's half the time, right? So hopefully it makes sense to you that that would be half of the job done. And in fact, that's true. To figure out how much work he gets done, you take the rate times your time. You take 1/12 times 6, or 6/12, which happens to be 1/2. All of those are correct. So when we talk about the rate and the time and the work, hopefully you might notice that your rate times your time worked equals your work done. And that would represent how much of a job you got done. So if he worked for 12 hours, he would have one job done. If he worked for 24 hours, he would be able to paint two houses, for instance. All right? So let's try one more. What if we start out the same way? Takes him 12 hours to get a job done. His rate is 1/12. But what if he works for 8 hours? Then we'd have 1/12 times 8. Easy way is to just write that as 8/12. And if you reduce it, that means 2/3. He gets 2/3 of the job done. All right. Assume it takes Mary 2/3 of an hour to clean a room. What is her rate per hour? Now, the tricky thing here is it only takes her 2/3 of an hour to clean the room. So she's going to be done with more than one job if she works for a whole hour. Does that make sense? So see if you could figure this out. How many rooms would she be able to clean in an hour? All right, so there's different ways you might consider this. You might say, well, let's break an hour up into three parts, right? So in 2/3 of an hour, she gets one job done, right? And then she gets a half a job done in the next third of an hour. So she actually gets 1.5 jobs done. So her rate per hour, that means how much does she get done in 1 hour? Rate per hour is 1.5 or 3/2. Now, the interesting thing here that I want you to note, it's the reciprocal of how long it takes her to do a full job. So if it takes somebody 2/3 of an hour to do something, the reciprocal of that 3/2 is their rate per hour. Just like with Tom, Tom's rate was 1/12, right, of a job per hour. Which was the reciprocal. Of 12, how long it took him to complete the job. Okay, so if it takes you X hours to do something, then your rate is 1 over x. It's the reciprocal. So let's go on to an actual work problem. Tom takes 12 hours to paint a house alone, but Don takes 6 hours to paint it. So Don's faster, isn't he? How long it would take if they work together? Okay, so we know that alone it takes Tom 12 hours. And does it tell us how long Don takes alone? Yes, he takes 6 hours. So their rates are the reciprocals, 1/12 and Don 1/6. Now in this problem, it is not telling us how long they're going to work together. So the question is, we're trying to figure out how long they have to work together to get the job done. A common mistake is to think it's just going to be in between 6 and 12, exactly halfway in between, and it's not going to be directly in between that. So it's not like it's going to take them 9 hours, because Don could get it done in 6 hours, so it's certainly not going to take more time when they work together. So here's one way of thinking about it. If you have two people working, if Don worked with somebody that was as fast as he was, they'd get done in half the time, 3 hours. And if Tom worked with somebody that was took as long as he did, 12 hours, they would get done in half the time, or 6 hours. So we know it's between 3 and 6 hours. And in fact, since Don's working pretty fast, it's going to be closer to 3 than 6. So this is just something to keep in mind. The answer should be in between 3 and 6 hours. All right, let's go back to the problem. We don't know their time, so that's the variable. So let's put in x. That's how long they're going to work together. And we know that the rate times time equals the work completed. So Tom's work completed is going to be 1/12 times x, or x over 12. And Don's is going to be 1/6 times x, which is x over 6. And what we do is we want them to finish one complete job. So to get the equation, we want Tom's work plus Don's work to be one complete job. So we've got x over 12 plus x over 6. Tom's work plus Don's work, right? Each of them get a certain amount of the job done, and we want them to complete exactly one job. All right, so now how do we solve this? Well, this is an equation with fractions. It's easier to multiply both sides by the least common denominator. So let's say I'm going to multiply both sides of the equation by 12, the least common denominator. So we're going to do 12 times x over 12 plus 12 times x over 6. And don't forget to multiply 12 on the right side of the equation as well. So we get x plus 2x equals 12. And now we get a pretty simple equation. 3x is 12, so x is going to be 4. So 4 hours. Now, does that make sense? This was our sort of estimate, that it was going to be in between 3 and 6 hours. So yes, 4 hours makes sense. All right, let's look at the original problem again. It says, how long would it take if they worked together? So we're looking for how much time. We got x was equal to 4, and x stood for the amount of time each of them worked. All right, so let's go back. Tom takes 12 hours to paint a house alone, but Don takes 6 hours to paint it. How long would it take if they worked together? What we found out was that their time, it looks like, was 4 hours. So we're going to check that. Tom would then get 1/12 times 4, or 4/12 of the job done, which is a third of the job. And Don would do 1/6 times 4, 4/6, which is 2/3. And so sure, Tom got a third of the job done, Don got 2/3 of the job done, and that adds up to one job, doesn't it? So it makes sense that it takes 4 hours. 4 hours working together. So that's how long it takes them to complete the job. And that is your first work problem.